Atas fatal keselamatan, Federasi The Secret Life of Nora terpaksa membatalkan beberapa aksi berbahaya. Enggan mengambil risiko kekurangan itu bagaimanapun tidak mengganggu perjalanan cerita.
Dengan set canggih berskala besar, produksi memerlukan kepakaran tinggi bagi memastikan kelancaran persembahan. Bukan sahaja perlu memanjat set setinggi 8 meter, pelakon juga perlu terbang terutama pada babak kedua musikal. Bagaimanapun, beberapa lagak ngeri masih boleh disaksikan dengan keselamatan menjadi keutamaan.
Lebih banyak dimasukkan dalam show ni, dan some things that didn't work technically kita terpaksa bawa keluar lah. Bila nak cuba buat secara, you know, when in technical rehearsals, apa yang tak jadi dan apa yang membabitkan keselamatan dan ada kemungkinan, you know, safety comes first for us. So apa yang tak boleh jadi, we don't take the risk.
Tiara menjelaskan setiap lakonan aksi akan dipantau sekurang-kurangnya dua kru.
Sebab nyawa kita tu di dalam tangan orang kan. But that's what after realizing yang show ini live dan anything can go wrong, kita adakan buddy system di belakang pentas, saling mencheck antara kita dan orang yang kendalikan safety and harness and wires and all that, they have to be so extra careful. Orang lain double check, triple check, and we have a rechecking system supaya pastikan yang semua orang terselamat.
Diarahkan Stephen Dexter dari West End London, The Secret Life of Nora turut dijayakan Ryan Silverman, Aznal Nawawi dan Adi Bahno. Pementasan berjalan sehingga 16 Oktober.
Bukan lagi epik sejarah atau kisah benar, The Secret Life of Nora mengisahkan seorang primadona yang secara tidak sengaja menjadi perisik. Pertaruhan terbaru Tiara menerima respons positif sejak dipentaskan di Istana Budaya Khamis lalu.
Actually, the costumes are lovely. I mean, they really dance very well. And actually, I'm quite impressed with Tiara singing. I didn't know that she could sing that well. This is the first time I hear her really. Her voice have improved her from the last that I heard when she sang her during Gulung Ledang.
The set actually rotated and became different things at all different times, and I thought the complexity of it was really interesting. I remember I was looking through it and I went, oh, I wasn't good. What's going to happen next? Mr. J, definitely. I thought he was a twisted, you know, I thought he's that sort of villain that everyone wants to be. He's super glamorous but evil, so I was really enjoying his character.
Saya suka setnya walaupun agak simple, tapi still memberi kita impact. Dari segi visual, penataan lampunya cantik, dan dari segi kelucuan juga kita terasa sebab dia selang-selikan bahasa Melayu dan bahasa Inggeris. Kemunculan macam Mamat Khalid tu memberi warna lucu pada pementasan ini.
Well, I really enjoyed it, and what I liked the most was that it was mixed Malay and English, which I thought is really nice because here in Malaysia nobody speaks, you know, entirely in English or entirely in Malay, and it was really nice to have also a character that was, you know, a foreigner that comes and, you know, is, you know, you have that blend with our local situation and local people, and I thought that was really nice. It was a nice balance.